Welcome to the Daily Show.
Thank you very much.
How are things going in life? Are you afraid? Are you stressed right now? Because you are, according to Forbes, a man who is a billionaire worth $51.7 billion. Elizabeth Warren, I've heard, is coming for you. Are you afraid? How are you feeling about this whole thing? Is there a war on the billionaires, or how do you feel about it?
I think there's a great discussion to be had about who should pay how much taxes. I personally would be fine with paying more. And yet the most... Hold on.
He hasn't said how much.
I think the most important thing, frankly, is that people just get the numbers. Look at what's going on today.
Right.
And then you can almost like assign a quota. You should pay this much tax. Uh-huh. You should pay that. But it's got to be based on what we want to do. What do we want to do with the money? How much? Who can pay?
Right.
What other expenses can we cut? Just get it right. And then the will of the people will decide what should happen. And I'll be okay with it.
That's really interesting.
Whatever it is.
Yeah, because you've always been one of the people who said, you've said, hey, I don't agree with this idea that the government can make the money it needs just by cutting costs. But at the same time, government has to do a better job of using the taxes that it collects. And as a billionaire, I'm willing to pay more. So you're not afraid in life. You're not, like, stressed every day. You're not, like, waking up in the middle of the night like, Elizabeth!
I wake up stressed every day. Are we gonna win tonight?
Oh, is that... Okay. Let's talk about...
I don't have any issues on the other front.
That's good. I feel like the Clippers now more than ever are not stressed. You have Kawhi Leonard on your team. You have an excitement in LA that I have never seen before. This is really a momentous occasion, and you're getting ready to build an arena for the LA Clippers, which, please correct me if I'm wrong here, apparently you're designing it so that the players can hear the crowd more, like the roar goes into the court.
We want it to be the most intense, hardcore, high energy basketball junkies building in the world.
I like the idea, but I was thinking, I was worried, like, what if acoustically it works too well, and then, like, the players can just hear, like, someone just talking in, like, the stands, and the person's like, hey, honey, pass the ketchup. And then the guy's like, pass? Wait, who said that? And then, like, it could throw off. You're also doing, like, augmented reality. But I don't understand what that means. You're saying, like, you're going to put people in the game, but how? What does that mean? What are you going to do?
We have a set of technology today. You watch the game, and in real time,
uh-huh,
it'll give you probability that somebody will make a shot based upon where people are standing,
wow,
who it is it a good shot, what can you expect out of that. It'll diagram the plays that are going on real time on the floor.
Wow.
We've got this live today because of rights. We're in, quote, alpha or beta test still.
Right, right, right.
But the stuff exists today. You know, there's limited stuff that does this today. There really is no first down marker in football on the field. It gets painted in by a computer. It's that concept on steroids.
Oh, I thought someone just ran out and did it every... You're teaching us things here, Steve. Teaching us things. Let's talk about the big reason you're here today. Let's talk about USA facts. It feels like we live in a world today where facts are no longer a thing. It feels like more and more people want to live in silos where they believe what they believe, and a fact is something that can be determined by the person who is absorbing the information. You've created a website that is geared towards facts. What is USA Facts?
USAfacts.org is a website. I got into this 4 or 5 years ago, and I just wanted to understand who pays how much taxes, what does the money get spent on, mm-hmm, and what are the outcomes we get for all of that?
Right.
And it was impossible to find. So I started just splunking around, trying to understand. My wife had made a comment about where our taxes go or don't go. Couldn't do it. Got into it and said, hey, I should share this with other people. It's very interesting to understand. And by the numbers. By the numbers.
Right, right, right.
You know, part of the problem with words is they're partisan. Numbers don't know how to be partisan, if
uh-huh,
you will.
Uh-huh.
And we've been pursuing it, you know, ever since. We published annual report by the numbers of government in the United States now,
right,
for 3 years.
It's interesting because it's a nonpartisan effort that you've put together where you've gone, this data comes from the government. It's compiled from different government departments and it's factual information, but nobody knows how to compile it until now. Like, you've gone and said, hey, if you want to know how much is being spent on schools in this district, you can find out. If you want to know how much is being spent on immigration or what your money's being used for, what the government's wasting on, spending on, etc., you can use this website. What have you learned, though, from the website? Is there anything that has changed your mind about how America works?
Yeah, there's a number of things that have really prompted me. If you had said to me 5 years ago, who really pays how much taxes in the U.S., I wouldn't have been able to tell you.
Right.
I wouldn't have been able to tell you there are people who pay more in taxes right now than they earn in income. That's
true.
Wow. And then they get benefited also by transfers that come from the government.
Right.
And you can decide whether you think, you know, whether that's a great situation or not.
Right.
We let our users decide what they decide on policy.
Right.
We'll give you the facts and you can decide what's good or bad. I'll give you another one. Only 33% of eighth graders, in this country are proficient in math.
33%.
But it's up.
Oh.
It's up over the last several years. Well,
yay.
Somebody can look at it and say progress is good.
Right.
But that's a judgment. But education spending at the same time?
Right.
Inflation adjusted? More than doubled.
That's actually interesting. So you've basically created this site because you wanted to break through the whole partisan breaking down of what news is and just go, here's a fact. A person at home can decide what that fact means. Some of the more interesting polls that you've conducted, though, on USA Facts have illuminated a few things. So, for instance, you've conducted some... We have a few of these slides here that we can pull up now, like some of the data facts. If you can pull them up, they're pulled. Like, for instance, how much do you trust information from the president? Republicans, 40%, right? Democrats, 5%. And then if you see, like, the not at all is, like, a big flip. Republicans are like, no, only 15% say not at all, but 61% of Dems. But I mean, that's a big... If you look at the next slide, for instance, we have another one that's really interesting. How much do you trust each source? Republicans don't trust public TV or radio, and they don't trust national TV news. And in the next slide, this one is even a little bit more disconcerting. What makes a fact likely to be true? If it's verified by scientists, Republicans are like, no, only 40%. Democrats say 72%. Verified by academics, 30% to 57%. So... This is just information that you're compiling for people. You don't even give anybody an opinion on this.
We do not. We explicitly don't give opinions. Now, this was a poll we ran. As you pointed out,
Right. Everything
else we do is government data, but we need to know what we're doing.
Right.
Just take even the thing about academics and scientists, because you can react one way or another.
Right.
The truth of the matter is, a lot of what you see out of economists is forecasts. And
right,
on every
right.
forecast, you'll see one on the right and one on the left, and they'll say different things. I don't know what you would think. At Microsoft, I didn't believe the forecast.
Uh-huh.
I only believe what had actually happened. So all of these things have context, and that's why we have to share what actually happened. There's a quote I'd like to give you from Madison.
Mm-hmm.
Something the effect of, a popular government without popular information or the ability to go get it is a prologue to a farce or even worse, a tragedy.
Huh. And so that's what
I mean, the facts... sort of start there with Madison.
So if I were to say to you, Steve Ballmer, as somebody who's been part of this USA Facts, what do you hope Americans would achieve by going to this website? What do you just want people to get from the website? Because it is free, it is nonpartisan, it's just facts that are compiled, but what are you hoping it will achieve?
I hope we can get to a point with not as much polarization, civilized dialogue. People can disagree about what to do, but at least be in the same place. We have a little fun thing coming out here soon for Thanksgiving. You're going to sit around a table with relatives, and
uh-huh.
people are going to disagree.
Right.
And they're going to want to scream and yell at each other. So we have a Thanksgiving fact sheet from USA Facts. Pull it out on your phone,
oh,
and you
wow.
can say, I'll get you the real data on that topic.
Oh,
boom!
Wow.
Special
oh,
for
wow.
Thanksgiving
well,
holiday.
Thanksgiving will never be the same. Thank you so much for being on the show. You can check out all the data at usafacts.org. Steve Ballmer, everybody.